Good morning, friends. Today we will be discussing about TDS relations. My name is Pankaj Dumka, assistant professor, JP University of Engineering and Technology, Guna. Before we start discussing about TDS relation, I would like to tell you something about the last video, which is basically the Maxwellian derivation of Maxwell's relation. Friends, in that there is a slight correction. PdV is displacement work, and I said it is flow work. Sorry, it is not flow work, it is displacement work. So let us start with TDS relation. Let us say that entropy is a function of temperature and volume. Then we can write this as TdS is del S by del T, keeping volume constant, dT, plus del S by del V, keeping temperature constant, dV. So if we multiply temperature on both sides, we will get T del S by del T, keeping volume constant, dT, plus T del S by del V, keeping temperature constant, dV. Now, we know from the first law of thermodynamics, when combined with the second law, that TdS is equal to dU plus PdV, or it is CV dT plus PdV. Because we know that del U by del T at constant volume is nothing but specific heat at constant volume. So that's why this. Now, if volume is constant, then what can be done here? This is zero. That simply means T del S at constant volume is CV del T at constant volume, or T del S by del T at constant volume is nothing but CV. And we have this del S by del T at constant volume here, in fact T multiplied with T. So replacing this term with this CV, we will get TdS is equal to CV dT plus T del S by del V at constant temperature dV. Now here comes the Maxwell equation. And you know that Maxwell equation, one of the Maxwell equations say V like this. This is one of the Maxwell equation. So replacing this del S by del V at constant temperature by del V by del T at constant volume, so you will get this. TdS is equal to CV dT plus T del P by del T at constant volume dV. This is my first TdS relation. Now moving ahead to second TdS relation. Let us say that entropy, specific entropy, is a function of temperature and pressure. Previously we said it is a function of temperature and volume. So so what can be done here is dS can be written as del S by del T, keeping pressure constant, dT, plus del S by del P, keeping temperature constant, dP. multiply both sides by temperature, we will get TdS is equal to T del S by del T at constant pressure dT plus T del S by del P at constant temperature dP. Now you know that one of the slight arrangement in the first law connected with second law can be written like this, that TdS is equal to dH minus VdP. And with the definition of specific heat at constant pressure, I can write this as Cp dT minus VdP. So friends, if pressure is a constant, this is a constant, then this will become zero and our final expression will be like this, that T del S by del T at constant pressure will be what? Will be Cp. And we have this here, T del S by del T at constant pressure. So replacing it by Cp. So what we'll get? We will get this. TdS is equal to Cp dT plus T del S by del P at constant temperature dP. This is the thing. Again, we have a Maxwell relation. What Maxwell relation? It says del S by del P at constant temperature is del V by del T at constant pressure. As we have moved in horizontal direction, so negative sign will come up. So replacing this term by this one, you will get TdS is equal to Cp dT minus T del V by del T at constant pressure dP. So this is your second TdS relation. This is a second TdS relation. Now moving on to third TdS relation, third and final TdS relation. Let us say that entropy is a function of this time pressure and volume. So by saying this, you mean that TS is equal to del S by del P at constant volume dP plus del S by del V at constant pressure dV. Now multiplying both sides by temperature, TdS is equal to T del S by del P at constant volume dP plus T del S by del V at constant pressure dV. Now here comes the importance of the third, of the second identity which we have seen in last video. And before that, first identity is also coming here. Let us say that what? That S, P, T and V, they are connected and connected such that this volume remains constant. By saying this, what I mean that del S by del P at constant volume into del P by del T at constant volume into del T by del S at constant volume is 1. So this del S by del P at constant volume can be written as del S by del T at constant volume into del t by del p at constant volume. Multiply both sides by temperature, T and T. And just now you have seen that this is what? This is Cp. Look here. T del S by del T at constant volume is Cv, sorry. T del S by del T at constant volume is Cv. So this is Cv del T by del P at constant volume. Now if I am saying, let us say that entropy, volume, temperature and pressure, they are connected such that this pressure is a constant. So what I can write here is del S by del V at constant pressure into del V by del T at constant pressure into del T by del S at constant pressure, and this is 1. So del S by del V at constant pressure can be written as del T by del V at constant pressure into del S by del T at constant pressure. Multiply both sides by temperature. This and this. Slight rearrangement. T del S by del T at constant pressure into del T by del V at constant pressure. What is this? This is nothing but T del S by del T at constant pressure. It is Cp. So this thing is Cp del T by del V at constant pressure. Hence, my original equation, after introducing this and this, will become TdS is equal to Cv del T by del P at constant volume dP plus Cp del T by del V at constant pressure. This is my third TdS relation. So we have developed all the TdS relation. TdS relation number 1, TdS relation number 2, and TdS relation number 3. Thank you for watching. If you liked my video, then please do subscribe. Thank you. Have a nice day.